Hello students, I'm here with another video from the chapter of class 7 Science NCERT book, that is chapter number 17, Forest Our Lifeline. Before starting today's video, I would like to tell you all that what all things we have discussed in this chapter. So we have seen the definition of forest. It is a large area which is covered with the trees and wild animals as well as the different varieties of the organisms. Okay. Then we have also seen about the structure of forest, children. After seeing the structure of forest, we found that there are three parts. I mean, there are three definitions or the words which is describing the structure of forest: the crown, canopy, and the understories. So we already have discussed all these things in details, and then after that I have given you a list of products which are being obtained as the forest product or from the forest. Okay, so we are completely dependent upon the forest, whether it is the for food purpose or whether it is for clothing purpose or whether it is for shelter purpose. Okay, so for our basic requirements, for our basic needs, we are dependent upon the forest. Means most of the times we are dependent upon forest as well as the forest products. Okay, so there is a need to protect these forests. So in this chapter we are reading the same thing. I mean, what importance this forest is having in our life, we are reading the same thing. In this chapter, there is one Professor Ahmed who took different children, many children with them. And then these children are, they are on the visit inside the forest. And then they found that in the forest, there are various animals, plants. They found that there are so many things, there are so many new things which are present over there. So they are fascinated. They are just seeing to these new different types of plants, animals, and the organisms which are present inside the soil as well as on the soil. Or then they are very much happy to see that they are gathering the information. Now, once they are gathering the information, they knew that the forest is full of amazing things. So why there is a need to cut the forest and make a factory? And one of the child has also asked that if we are cutting few trees from this forest, then what difference is it going to make? But this is not a fact that if you are cutting few trees from this forest, this is going to bring out your needs. I mean, it is going to make a difference. How we are going to study that this is going to make a difference, that is being told by his teacher, the child's teacher. Then after that, he told that there are certain things, important processes, functions which is being carried out by these forests. Okay, and if we are cutting these few trees, and if we are cutting means at one place, if we are cutting few trees, then are not only one single forest. There are several forests, and several few numbers could make a large difference. Okay, somewhat a few trees are being cut in one place or in one forest. Similarly, 10-15 trees are being cut, or 50 trees are being cut in the different forest, and again 50 trees are being cut in another forest, for example. And everybody is saying that we are cutting only few trees. Now, is this going to make a difference or not? 50, 100 plus 50, 150 trees have been cut down, or they are being laid down. Then is it going to make any difference? Then what would your answer will be? So the answer would be yes, it is going to make a difference. Because if we are collecting few things, if we are collecting the few number, it is going to make a large number. And that large number is going to impact the overall effect. It is going to affect in overall conditions. Okay. So this is the fact that this forest is going to, if the forests are present, if they are present, they are going to affect in a positive way. And if the forests are not present, then they are going to impact the life of the human beings, impact the life of each and every organism in the negative way. Okay. Now, next thing which we have to discuss in this chapter is about the food chain and the food web. So last class, I also told you about what is the meaning of the food chain and how they're interconnected with each other to form a food web. If we need to write down the difference between the food chain and the food web, we could write down that in food chain, small number of animals are there, and in the food web many organisms are being included. One organism is a food for other several food chain. Okay, so and each and every organism, whether it is a tiny ant or it is a big elephant, it is going to make a difference if the absence is there in the forest. If the absence is there in the food chain, their absence is going to mark, their absence is going to affect the complete ecosystem, the complete forest, the complete earth. Okay, so in, if we have to maintain this ecosystem, if we have to maintain the number or the different things, then what would happen? This is going to affect the life of the human beings in a very even the animals or the organisms. If each and every organisms are present, if each and every organism is present in its own way in the forest, each and every organism is doing its work. Okay, whether it is the microorganism like bacteria, which we found that they are the saprophytes, they are removing all the waste products from the forest, and if they are going to die, then what would happen? So many waste products would be present all over the forest floor, and then that could also make the problem would arise. Some animals would die, even the air which is present, which is coming from this forest, is going to be affected in a bad manner, in an adverse condition. Okay, so next thing which we need to discuss here is these decomposers. They are forming the brown material or the dead organic matter, which turns into brown color. This is said to be as humus, and this adds nutrient to the soil. And one fact that nothing is waste in the forest. This fact, nothing goes waste in the forest. Okay, so this is a fact that nothing goes waste in the forest, is that if we talk about the nutrient, if we talk about the minerals, which is being absorbed by these trees from the soil, then again they are living, they are utilizing this material, these are utilizing the nutrition. And then after that, what happens? After utilizing the materials or the different minerals, then what would happen? Once these forests, these trees are being dead, then they would be again mixed with soil. And once they are mixed with soil, so whatever nutrient they have been taking, it would be again passed to this. The soil is again would be full of nutrients as the animals or the plants are being dead and they are getting mixed with the soil. Okay, so this is what is about. Nothing goes waste in the forest. Whatever is being taken up, whatever is being withdrawn from the soil, from whatever is being withdrawn from the forest, is returned back in the form of minerals, in the form of the various materials. Okay, now if these materials are utilized, then the minerals or the things are being returned back. Okay, and this is a fact that whatever things are being taken up, it is going to be returned back in the forest. Okay, so if you see, in the water cycle is also maintained similarly. Okay, so how is this water cycle getting maintained? It is getting maintained because of the forest itself. And where is this water going? This water is again coming back into the forest also. Some part of this water is also coming back in the forest. Why? Because the clouds are there, they are going to form the transpiration is happening, condensation is happening, cloud formation is happening, again the precipitation would happen, and it is going to add the water in the forest floor also. Now, once the forest floor is absorbing water, what would happen? This is again giving rise to different more trees, because many seeds are already present, seed dispersal is happening. The animals, plants, birds, all these are responsible for the seed dispersal, and they are adding the seed in the soil. And once the nutrition is there, humus is there, water is there, sunlight is also coming, then what would happen? The plant is going to germinate, the seed is going to germinate and form a plant. Then in the after the plant, it is going to form a tree. Okay, so this fact is but natural, that if the seeds are present, they are again going to form the tree, After some time, after some years. So whatever trees are being these are being laid down, or they are being dead because of their age, and then what happens, they are going to fall down because of the rainfall or any condition, then some more trees are being given up from this forest floor. So each and everything is being balanced. Okay, the things, the nutrients, the water, the trees, even the animals, the plants, all these are getting maintained. They are under the balanced condition. Once this balanced condition is being disturbed, it is going to disturb the complete environment. It is going to disturb the complete environment of the earth. Okay, so this was about the food chain, food web, and even the balance which is being maintained by this. By the fact that all the things are going to be returned back from where they have been taken up from in the forest. Okay, so next thing, whatever what is present over here, we talked about the scavengers also. Okay, so here in this book of your science is telling us some more facts to be studied. I'll just read out the facts quickly so that you would understand what is given over here. Paheli reminded Professor Ahmed that he had not explained why forests are called green lungs. But I have explained you in the very first, in the beginning of the chapter, that why these forests are said to be as the green lungs. Okay, as you know that the lungs are the main respiratory organ where the blood is being, where the air is being purified. Okay, the air is being purified. We have read this in a chapter called respiration. Okay, we have seen this. Fine. Now, from where are we getting these oxygen? So we are getting the oxygen from the trees, and in return of what we are getting this oxygen? The plants are there who are ready to take up carbon dioxide, which is useless for us. They are utilizing that carbon dioxide and they are giving us what? Whatever, what is being given? They are giving us oxygen in return. So this carbon dioxide, which is waste for us, is taken up by the trees, or the forest you could say, because trees are present in a large number in the forest. Now these forests take up carbon dioxide, they inhale carbon dioxide, and once after doing photosynthesis, they are utilizing it for photosynthesis. And once they are doing photosynthesis, they are returning back oxygen in the nature. Okay, in the atmosphere. So they are taking up carbon dioxide and they are returning oxygen in the atmosphere, because this process called photosynthesis utilizes carbon dioxide as the raw material. Okay, so this carbon dioxide is absorbing is being absorbed by the trees, and then what happens, this is going to give rise to this converts this carbon dioxide into oxygen, and then it is being given to the animals and the human beings for their utilization. Okay, so this is about the role which is being played, the balance which is being maintained between carbon dioxide and the oxygen by the help of these forests. So next, what is being written over here is that the forests are being called green lungs because of the fact that this carbon dioxide is going to be balanced with oxygen, and this oxygen and carbon dioxide both are being balanced with the trees, because trees take up carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and they return oxygen, which is useful for us. Okay, so this maintains the balance of the carbon dioxide and oxygen because of photosynthesis. The plants help in providing oxygen for the animals for respiration. They also maintain the balance between oxygen and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, and that is the reason because of which the forests are called the green lungs. Okay, so forests are called green lungs because they are maintaining the balance between green signifies the color of trees, which is green in color. Okay, now these trees are said to be as the lungs because of the fact that this helps in the purification of they helps in the, they help in the purification of the air. They purify air. Okay, they purify air, and which maintains the balance of oxygen. Okay, which maintains the balance for oxygen. These plants, this give oxygen. They take up carbon dioxide from whom? From animals, and they maintain and this oxygen is getting utilized by these animals, whereas the animals give out carbon dioxide, which is taken up by the plants. This is how this carbon dioxide and the oxygen is getting balanced. So this oxygen, this carbon dioxide, what happens? This oxygen is going to give rise they help the animals. And from where we are getting oxygen? We are getting oxygen from the plants as a result of photosynthesis. So this balance is giving, it is purifying the air. This is going to purify the the air which is being present in the places. And plants are present everywhere, which are going to purify, which and same thing is happening inside the lungs also. Inside the lungs also, what is happening? The air is getting purified. Okay, so the function remains same. So that is why its color is green and it is said to be as green lungs, but the function remains same, where the lungs also they also purify the air, and they are also helpful in the breathing. They also helps us in the survival. Similarly, these plants, these trees, they are taking up carbon dioxide, which is bad for us, and they give us oxygen, which is good for us. So this maintains the balance between oxygen and carbon dioxide very nicely. The children saw clouds forming in the sky. Bujo recalled that he has also learned about water cycle in class 6. Okay, so one thing is that they are called green lungs. So this is again one function, it purifies the air. Fine, then the next function is that we have learned about water cycle. Okay, we have learned about water cycle. Now, what do you mean by this water cycle, children? This water cycle is a cycling process, or it is a continuous circulation of water in the Earth's atmosphere. Now, how this is getting in the Earth's environment, how this water is getting cycled, or how it is getting circulated? Very, it is very simple that this water cycle has three steps. One is the evaporation, then second is the condensation, third is the precipitation. So these are the three main steps of water cycle. And the first, very first step, that is the evaporation, which is taking place from the surface of the water body, and also which is taking place from the earth's from the surface of the trees, from the plants. So these plants are going to they are going to give rise to the different these are going to do one process called transpiration. This transpiration is nothing but it is the excessive the water which is present in the excess amount, in the extra amount in the plants, it is getting evaporated from the aerial parts of the plant. Or aerial parts of the plant means from the surface of the plant, from the leaves, from the branches, from the green stem. All these are all these are helpful in the transpiration. So what is this transpiration? It is the evaporation from the plants. So if it is taking place from the water body, it is said to be as evaporation. And if the water vapor is arising, it is being given up by the trees, by the plant surface, it is said to be as the transpiration, children. Okay, now this transpiration and this evaporation is adding water to the clouds. Now these clouds are being formed, and these clouds are the result of condensation, which is taking place after, as a second step of water cycle. Now what would happen if condensation is taking place? In the next step, what would happen? After the condensation, what would happen? The rainfall would happen. The precipitation would happen. Okay. So this precipitation results in the rainfall, and also the water is being coming back on the earth's surface because it was evaporated and it has gone into the clouds, and from the clouds again it has been falling down, and then it is again reaching to the water body, or it is also reaching back on the earth's surface. So this is known as a water cycle. Okay. Now these trees take in water from These trees take in water from their roots and release water vapor in the earth, in the atmosphere with a process called evaporation. But there is a difference between evaporation and the transpiration, children, okay? Evaporation and transpiration. Now, both these processes are the movement of water, the form of vapor. Water vapor is there. So this water vapor is arising from the surface. Now, the surface differs here. Evaporation takes place from the water bodies. It takes place from the water bodies. Okay? And this transpiration takes place from the plant's surface. Okay, from the body of the plants, or the trees, we could rather say. Okay? Now, why this is taking place? Excessive, the sunlight is there. The sunlight is converting because of the sun's heat. The water is getting converted in the form of vapor and it rises up. Similarly, this sun rays are falling on the leaves, on the tree, of the trees. So what would happen? The excessive amount of water which is present in the leaves, it is getting evaporated. But here this is not said to be as evaporation, children. Please make sure. This is said to be as a transpiration. Okay, this is known by another word called transpiration. So transpiration means it is the movement of it is the means it is the evaporation of excessive amount of water from the plant surface, and because of which what happens? It this water adds up. This water vapor is going to be added up in the clouds, and then in return, what would happen? It is going to fall down in the form of the rainfall. Okay, we'll get precipitation, and again the water would be circulated in the earth. Okay, on the earth's surface. The next thing what is given over here is, if there were few trees, then how would water cycle be affected? Will it be affected or not? So are these is this water cycle is being directly related with the trees or the forest? So what would be your answer? So the answer is yes, it is being directly affected. Means if lesser trees are there, if fewer trees are there, the process of transpiration, process of evaporation is going to be disturbed. Less evaporation, less transpiration, which means less cloud formation, which in turn getting less rainfall. So these cloud formation, these forests are responsible even for the water, maintaining this water cycle. Why? Because this is very easy now to understand. This water cycle is dependent upon this forest. Okay, so this forest is going to give rise to this transpirational phenomenon. Because of this transpirational process, what would happen? It is going to add up water in the clouds, and these clouds in turn they are giving us the rainfall, and this also maintains the water cycle. Okay, so fewer trees, then fewer evaporation, fewer transpiration, fewer amount of the rainfall would happen. So this is how water cycle would be affected if there are lesser trees in the forest. Okay, so this is about the water cycle and its maintenance. Now we move on to the next topic, next paragraph, which is given over here. Tibu told them that forest is not just a home to the plants and animals. Many people also live in forest. Means it is not only the home for the animals and the plants. These are not only the home for the organisms, children. It is also the home for the human beings also. Some of the people are also dependent upon the forest. They are directly or indirectly dependent upon the forest. Okay, so how they are directly and indirectly dependent? As Tibu was one of the child who was living in the village which is nearby to that forest, and these cattles, they are going to graze in the forest area. So with the help of those cattles, this Tibu was earning his livelihood, and then these animals also were dependent upon the grazing fields, the grass which was present in the forest. That is why this Tibu and the friends and this Professor Ahmed and the children they met with each other. Okay, because this Tibu was living in that particular area, and he knows the places in the forest, and that is why he became friend, and he was making them all to visit the forest very easily, as he was knowing all the names of the plants, trees, animals, birds, and even also the uses of these plants and the products. Okay, so he also told that there are not only animals and the birds, there are human beings also who are living in the forest. Okay, they are living in the forest and they are dependent upon forest in the direct way. Fine, some of them are being some of them belong to different tribes. Tibu explained that these people depend mostly on forest. The forest, they are mostly dependent upon forest, as he was knowing very well that he is also dependent upon the forest. Why? Because he also belonged to that particular tribe. Okay, so tribal people are there who are looking after these forests, and mostly they only live beside these forests, and they are helping, they are saving the forest also, and they are directly dependent upon the forest children. Okay, because their lives are dependent upon forest. So next thing, what would happen here in this lesson is that the forest provides them food, shelter, water, and medicine. Okay, so this forest is providing food, shelter, water, and medicine. Fine. Now what happens, they have traditional knowledge about the medicinal plants in the forest. So they are even dependent upon what all things are there in the forest, because of which these tribal people are living. Why they are living? Because these forests are helping them. How they are helping? By giving forest products. Because they are dependent upon the forest products. Who are dependent? These tribal people. Okay, these tribal people are dependent upon the different forest and its products. Okay, so the next thing which they get food, they get shelter, what do they get? They get shelter. And also they are dependent for water. Okay, then next, what they are dependent? They are dependent for medicines. They are dependent upon medicines. Why? Because these forests are helpful in providing all these things. They are dependent for the food, for shelter, for medicines, for spices, even for their clothes also, they are dependent upon the forest products. Okay, so this is how forests are helping these people. Even the shelter is also being given. It is the home for these tribal people. Okay, now next, what is given over here is they have traditional knowledge about the medicinal plant. Now what do you mean by traditional knowledge? Traditional knowledge means that the traditions which we follow, everybody knows. As I take the name of, if I take a name of the festival, for example, if I take the name of the festival like Holi, then what would you feel? How would you recognize that if we are talking about Holi, it means we are talking about colors. It is, why do you know that Holi is related with the colors? If I talk about Diwali, we are relating this Diwali festival with the diyas, okay, with the candle, with the light. Okay, similarly, if we talk about Eid, then it means that you are just relating the things with the sweet dish which is being prepared. Okay, we just connect the seving with the Eid. Okay, so what is, how you can connect the things? We can connect the things because we are getting all these knowledge from the tradition, from the traditional way. Long back also people were celebrating this Holi with the help of colors. I mean, we are using the colors for celebrating Holi. We were using the lights for celebrating Diwali. Similarly, we were using the semai for celebrating the Eid. Okay, now this knowledge has been transferred from traditions. These are the customs, these are the rules, these are the different ways by which are constant from long time, and you know that if this knowledge is there, it will be transferred to the next generation. Okay, similarly, this traditional knowledge of finding out the plants, and this has a medicinal value, this is being given by the different, I mean, this is being, we are getting in the form of tradition. Okay, how do you know that this tulsi, this plant tulsi is having the medicinal value? Okay, so we know that it is having the medicinal value because we have been given this knowledge from our from the parents or from the grandparents. Okay, from the great grandparents. Fine. So we get this information traditionally. Okay, so this is about the fact that these tribal people also were having the knowledge about these medicinal plants, and they were getting this knowledge in the tradition itself. Okay, so they got to know that these plants are utilized for which purpose. While Bujo was drinking water from the small stream, he saw that some deers were crossing the stream. Okay, and then they disappeared in the bush. Now they disappeared in the bushes, and where they have gone, we will discuss this thing in the next class. And that's all for today, children. We have discussed about the facts that the forests, some of the roles of forest. Okay, the major important role or the major role of the forest is in maintaining the water cycle, in maintaining the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide. It also is known as the green lungs. Okay, so all these facts we got to know in today's video. Now this Bujo was drinking water in the stream, and he saw that some deer were there, and these deers have crossed the stream and they disappeared in the bushes. Now where they have gone, we'll discuss this in the next class. Okay, so that's all for today's video. I will meet you all in the next video with the next topic to be discussed in this chapter.